Since FileMaker 16, many developers have adopted using JSON functions to pass script parameters and script results. It is a very convenient way of passing multiple parameters in one go. However, sometimes it is tedious to spend time writing many set variable script steps just to parse out the values from a script parameter. Welcome back to the channel. This is Wei Hao at Direct Impact Solutions. In today's video, I will show you a custom function I created to automatically parse out all values in the JSON script parameter and automatically set variables with them. This is what a typical JSON script parameter looks like. In this example, we have six key value pairs that we want to pass to a script as its script parameter. Traditionally, to parse out these values, we will use several set variable script steps, each using a JSON getElement function to get the value of each key. I use the same naming convention to name my JSON keys as well as my variables. So when I parse JSON values to set variables, I typically just name my variables the same as their corresponding keys. So I thought, if I always use my keys to name my variables, can I automate this so I don't have to type everything? So how do we automate setting variables? Creating a subscript is the first idea that comes to mind. I can easily loop through all keys in a JSON object using the loop script step and then use set variables to parse them. But given what we know about variable scopes, these variables are local to the subscript, which means my parent script won't have access to it. So no, I cannot use subscripts to parse variables I intended to use in my parent script. You might be thinking, then why don't you use global variables? As a best practice, we should minimize the number of global variables we use, as it's easy to use them under the wrong context and cause issues. If you're not familiar with variable scope, we've created a video of this topic, linked in the description below. Please check it out. What else can we use to set variables besides the obvious set variable script step? I can see some of you know the answer. We can use the let function and the while function to set variables, including local variables. In my case, I need to use both. I need the while function for looping and the let function for creating the variable. If you're not familiar with the while function, well, we have a video about that too, and it's linked in the description below. So now we know how to loop and how to set variables using functions within the scope of the current script. How do we make the variable name dynamic? The answer is the evaluate function. The evaluate function will evaluate the expression given to it. We will dynamically construct let functions based on the data in the JSON script parameter. Then we will use the evaluate function on these expressions to create variables dynamically. Do be careful when using the evaluate function. It is a great way to add a layer of abstraction to your solution, but make sure you know what you're doing. Let's create the function. I'll create this in the data viewer first, so it's easier to test and debug. We will start with the while function. For the first parameter, we need to initialize some variables. We know we need the script parameter, so I should set a variable for that. Then, I need to know what I'm looping through. In this case, I'm looping through keys in the JSON. So I should list all keys using the JSON list keys function. And we should count how many keys are in there so we know when to stop. And since our looping condition is based on the number of keys, we should have a loop counter too. Here I name my loop counter I out of habit. Next, the loop condition. Under what circumstances should the loop continue to run? For us, as long as there are more keys to evaluate, the loop should run. So the condition should be, if I is less than equal to the total key count, then it should run. In addition, I want to add another condition on the JSON input to make sure it is not empty. After that is the logic parameter. We will start by getting the key for the current loop. After that, I'm double checking the key exists using a custom function from Todd Geist. The source is linked in the description below. And of course, after getting the key, we want to get the value as well. So here, we use JSON getElement to parse out the value. Now, this is where the magic happens. Let's think about what do we want our let function to look like. It should be a very simple one where we set a local variable like this in the first parameter. And since we don't need it to return anything, the second parameter can simply be an empty string. If this is our goal, then the expression should look like this. After we have our expression, we can use the evaluate function to actually create the variable. We can certainly tweak this part, so instead of constructing one let function per loop, it constructs one large let function that set all variables in one go. I'm not going to do it in the video. If you want to do that, I'll leave this to you. And of course, since the loop condition depends on the loop counter, we need to increase the loop counter by one. Otherwise, we get stuck in an infinite loop. This is pretty much what we need. Of course, after we done this in the data viewer, we need to transfer that into an actual custom function. So here I have created a custom function called JSON pass script parameter. Now let's see it in action. I have two buttons here. One uses the traditional method to parse out variables one at a time using the set variable script step. The other one uses the custom function I just created. When I click on these buttons, the value in this field will be passed to the script. And as you can see from the data viewer, both scripts create the same set of local variables to store the parsed out script parameters. If I want to add another key value pair like this, for the traditional method, I will need to update my script to add another set variable script step to parse out the new value. But for the custom function method, since it's data-driven and dynamic, I don't have to do anything. This demo file is available for download, linked in the description. That's the end of the video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We publish FileMaker videos every week. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.